Okay, good evening everyone. In the last class, we have completed this portion. Yes or no? PPC, we have completed, na, cement? I'm waiting for your response.
Sir?
In the last class, we have completed this portion, no? PPC.
Yes, sir. Sir, screen is not working.
Screen is not seen.
Yes, sir.
Screen is visible now?
No, sir.
For others?
Visible, sir.
Yes, sir.
Visible, no?
Visible, sir.
It's a problem with your mobile, I think. For everyone, it is visible? Screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. In the last class, we have completed this portion. So we'll begin with the next type of cement. What is that cement? Air entraining cement. So air entraining cement, what do you mean by that one? Normal cement, some chemicals will be added. Normal cement, some chemicals will be added so that a thin layer of air or thin layer of chemical is surrounding that one. Thin, it is surrounding this one. When you add water and when you mix, no, small air bubbles will be formed. Small air bubbles will be formed. So this type of air bubbles which will form, and that cement is called as air entraining cement. How you manufacture? You manufacture by using small amount of air entraining agent with the Portland cement clinker. Portland cement clinker at the time of grinding. Okay, na? Is it clear? This point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Prajwal, is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, na? So, what are the different compounds which we are adding to the clinker? Alkali salts, synthetic detergent, calcium lignosulfide, and some calcium salts. These are the chemicals added to the clinker to make air entraining cement. Okay, na? What is the quantity here? Less than 0.1%, less than 0.1% of the chemicals are added in the powder form or in the liquid form. Sometimes, apart from chemicals, you can add animal fats or vegetable fats, oils or acids. Some other things which we are adding are wetting agents, aluminium powder, hydrogen peroxide. What are these? These are the chemicals which, when combined with water plus cement, they will generate millions of tiny, micro, small air bubbles. So that is why we call it as air entraining admixture. So these air bubbles which are formed, these things will modify the property. If any extra thing is there, no, it will obviously, it is going to modify the property. What are the properties which are going to be affected? Workability, segregation, bleeding. It will improve the workability, it will decrease the segregation and bleeding. These two are bad things for concrete. Workability is depending upon the nature of work. So air bubbles which are formed during the mixing with water will change the property, such as workability is changed, segregation and bleeding is controlled. Okay, now, next type of cement is colored cement. What is happening in colored cement? Some base material is taken for this coloring pigment is added. In simple words, what you can say? How to manufacture the colored cement? Some base material is selected. What are the base material? White cement or gray cement are the base material. To this, you are using some coloring pigments so that you can get red cement or brown cement. What is the percentage? Less than 5 to 10% pigment you are adding. How the pigment should be selected? pigment should not alter the properties of cement. Pigment should only impart color. Other than giving color, it should not change any property. That is why selection of pigment is very, very important. Selection of pigment is very, very important. So generally, the process of manufacture of this Portland cement, white Portland cement, which we are taking as a base for colored cement, is same. Only the raw materials are changed here. What is the raw materials here? You are selecting limestone, which is present at Jodhpur in Rajasthan. Which is of pure quality of limestone, that is selected for what? To make the white cement. So Birla White and JK White are the two companies. What are the raw materials? Pure limestone. Okay. Other than that, you can use China clay, where iron content is less than this. Okay. Fuel used here is RFO fuel. RFO fuel is nothing but refined furnace oil. Okay. Refined furnace oil. Apart from that, white limestone, you can use seashells and corals to give the white cement. So this pigment is added and colored cement is obtained. Is that okay? Everyone, this point is clear?
Yes, sir.
Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Everyone, it is clear, na?
Yes, sir.
Okay, everyone should reply, huh? Yes or no, what you have done? Okay, what understood or not, you should reply. Hydrophobic cement. What do you mean by hydro? Hydro means water. Phobic means it is not ready to combine with water. Suppose one place is there, construction of a dam. So that is very, very far away from city, So there should be a storage of cements, no? For the long-term construction of the dam, they should store. In rainy season, if moisture is there, then what will happen? These stored cement bags will start getting hard. And you cannot use that cement. To control that property, to control that problem, you are using hydrophobic. Means what? If it is opposite to water, it is suddenly it is not mixing with water. Okay. How that is done? By mixing some oleic acid or stearic acid. By mixing these acids to the cement manufacturing, the cement will become hydrophobic. So that it is not reacting with water easily. So there is a water repellent form is formed, water repellent film, thin coating, so that longer storage transport is possible. When that cement is mixed with aggregates, no? That layer is going to be broken down and normal cement reaction is going to take place. Understand? That thin coating of that oleic acid is there, no? Water repellent material. Once it comes in contact with aggregate during mixing, that time that layer will break down and normal water will come in contact with cement and naturally hydration will take place. So this type of cement is used where high rainfall is occurring. High rainfall, high humidity, longer storage is there, no? There you can use this type of cement. Clear, no? Hydrophobic cement. Everyone, I'm asking everyone to reply. Everyone. Again and again, I will not tell. Okay, na? Simply, whenever I ask understood or not understood, all persons should tell. All persons should give response. Understood or not? No?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. Now, what is this masonry cement? Masonry cement is having the property of cement plus lime. When you add lime and cement together, it will form what? Masonry cement. It is good in strength, which is taken from cement, and which is good in workability, which is taken from lime. Lime will give good workability. Cement will give good strength. So when you combine these two, you will have a very good cement. That cement is called as masonry cement. It will have masonry cement. So it is having workability, very good water retention, less shrinkage, good extensibility. All the things are used in the masonry cement. Okay, na? Apart from adding lime, you can also add air entraining, and you can also add mineral admixture to make that masonry cement. Okay, na? Is it clear this point?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Everyone. Everyone.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Why you are not replying, Baba? Everyone. Why you are not replying? I am asking everyone, no? Whether you have understood or not. Please reply. Whether this point is clear, masonry cement. I am asking again.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, next type of cement is expansive cement. Generally, what is happening? A cement is there. When you add water, it will start reacting. It will form gel. And slowly, slowly, it is going to shrink. No? Shrink means what? Shrink means reduction in volume. So this reduction in volume is called as a shrinkage. Whether in some cases where you are anchoring the bolts, or in grouting operation, what will happen if that cement is shrinked? What will happen if cement is shrinked? The bolts will come out. Grouting will be not in perfect place. To avoid that type of problem, you are using expansive cement. What do you mean by expansive cement? It will not shrink. It will stay its original volume. It will stay its original volume. So that is why no shrinkage. Otherwise, you can call it as expansive cement. It's called as expansive cement. Expansive cement does not allow any shrinkage. Where it is used? In grouting, in pre-stressing material, in grouting, in all other things, it is used. What is generally added here, which is making that expansion? Sulfo-aluminate clinker. Here, some additional material is added. What is that? Sulfo-aluminate clinker, which we call it as a stabilizer. Up to 20%. Up to 20% or 15%. You can add this stabilizer to make the cement as expansive cement. Next type of cement is IRS, Indian Rail Sleepers. What is the requirement here? It should be high early strength giving. The cement you are using here in the sleepers of the railway, it should be high early strength giving. So what compound you should add here? High C3S. By adding high C3S, you will get high early strength. So that is why the cement is called as IRS sleeper. Indian Rail Sleeper 40 grade. Are you understand? These are the sleepers which are made from high C3S content. Okay. Next is oil well cement. Suppose you are pumping the oil. You are excavating from the oil well. This is the ground level. Let us say you are making a drilled hole like this to get the oil. Okay, na? And once you reach that oil, you will put some steel pipes, steel casings. And there is a gap between this excavated ground and steel casing pipe. Suddenly, oil may escape from here also. No, there is a chance. No, oil may escape from here also. No, from the sides of the steel casing and between this space, from the ground space. So to avoid that one, you want to inject the cement grout. So what is happening here? If you put normal cement grout, it may get stuck here only. It may get solidified. It may get hard here only. Because high temperature and high pressure is there. Okay, na? This oil well cement, special purpose cement, what it will do? It will go to the bottom of this zone. There it will get hard. So that no oil, no gases will escape. So this is called as oil well cement. So generally, they are adding retarders. To the cement. So that is why the name given as oil well cement. What is the function of retarder? Retarder will slow down the chemical reaction. Retarder will slow down the chemical reaction so that cement will go to the bottom. Cement grout will go to the bottom and it will get hard there. Okay. So temperature may be 175 degrees Celsius. Till that temperature, the concrete should be in mobile condition. So here what you have added? Retarders. You have added retarders. Okay, na? Whether this point is clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now next, ready set cement. What do you mean by this ready set cement? Suddenly there is a damage in the road. To repair that damage, you should be using concrete which is very high early strength giving, high early strength. So repair of concrete road, pavement, slip forming, their strength is also important and time is also important. So there you can use a ready set. Means what? Within very shortest time, it will get set. That is the point here. Shortest time will get set. Okay, no? How that property? Within 10 minutes, it will start setting. Okay. Within 6 hours, it will give good strength. It is giving a lot of heat. A lot of heat during the reaction. Okay. So that is why it is good in cold weather concreting. It is good in cold weather concreting. But it is not good in sulfate resistance. It is not good in sulfate resistance. So generally where it is used, very high strength if it is required, patch of repair works, emergency repairs, quick releasing the formwork, slip forming, construction between the tides in coastal area. In all these conditions, ready set cement is used. Ready set cement is used. Okay. This is clear, this point.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
See, others are quite only. Only 2 persons have answered.
Yes, sir.
What happened to others? Harish, Irshad, Manoj, Nakshatra, Nandita, Nehal, Prajwal, Shruti.
Yes, sir.
Why you are not?
Yes, sir.
Why you are not playing? So many times I am asking, no? Next type of cement, high alumina cement. So here major component, what is added here? Major component is added is aluminium ore. Aluminium materials are added so that it will become high alumina cement. Important function of using this one is it will give very, very high early strength. It will give very, very high early strength. So the name given is high alumina cement. Its property is very high early cement. So you are adding what? Alumina, calcareous materials and grinding to the very fine powder. Grinding to the very, very fine powder. So fusion is going to take place in 1600 degrees Celsius in which location? In the furnace, in the kiln, in the furnace or in the kiln. Later on, that is taken outside, cooled into the small pieces and again it is grounded. Taken outside from the kiln, small pieces will be made and it is grounded to the very, very fine powder so that its property of 3000 square centimeter per gram is obtained. That is called as a specific area. The unit of fineness is it is measured in specific area. So that is specific area is per square centimeter per gram. Square centimeter per gram. So high alumina content has what are the things? CA. CA means what? Calcareous material and aluminous material will combine with water, will form CaH. Will form CaH. What is that CaH? Monocalcium aluminate dehydrate. Monocalcium aluminate dehydrate. Now next, this monocalcium dehydrate will break down into this gel. Will break down into this gel plus this compound plus water. So this C3AH6 is called as tricalcium alumina hexahydrate, which is the strength giving material. Which is the strength giving material. It's the only this thing. Try to understand basically calcium aluminum compounds are grounded fine, mixed, burnt in kiln, produced again, made into small pieces, and water is added to give the compound which will give high strength, Why it is used? To get the high early strength, okay, for structural use, for other things, high early strength. See here, most advantage of high alumina cement is it is very high rate of strength development, within 6 to 8 hours the total strength, 20% of the total strength is achieved, okay na, whether that is clear, high alumina cement.
Yes sir.
Next type of cement is refractory. What do you mean by refractory? Wherever high temperature, such as a furnace, such as blast furnace, such as kiln, any place where burning is going on, the inside coating, using refractory material or refractory cement or refractory concrete. How to get this refractory? Why we are using this one? To counteract the high temperature of 1300 degrees Celsius. It should withstand that much of temperature. To have that much strength, you are using what as a raw material? You are using a crushed fire brick. Crushed fire brick as a raw material for cement manufacturing. So other materials such as sillimanite, carborundum, dead burnt magnesite. These are the raw materials used in refractory concrete. Where it is used? In furnace, in coke ovens, in boilers, in so many cases it is going to be used. That point is clear. Refractory.
Yes sir.
Okay. Next is very, very high strength. So in that first category is macro defect free. Normal cement, whatever may be the condition, there will be small defects, small cracks generally present in normal cement concrete. But in this MDF cement concrete, these cracks are somehow removed. How that property is achieved? By adding some polymers. We call it as water soluble polymers of 4 to 7%. The number 4 to 7% of the water soluble polymers are added to the normal cement to make that one as MDF, macro defect free, which will give very, very high strength. In that, no air, no cracks, nothing is there, strong. Okay, so some of the chemical compounds are given. Okay, poly propolymethyl cellulose, polyacrylamide of hydrolyzed polyvinyl acetate. Don't worry about all those things. If you write MDF is prepared by adding 4 to 7% of water soluble polymers, that's all. That is sufficient. No need to worry this one. Okay, na? Apart from that, you can control the particle size. Also, by adding very, very fine and fine particles to the concrete, you can increase the strength. So this is called as control of particle size distribution. So by adding this water soluble polymers and by adding this controlling this particle size distribution, the strength may get 300 MPa or 150 MPa like that. High strength is obtained. Okay, so that much is available. Okay, second process, one is MDF to give high strength. Second is the densely packed. Densely packed means what? Normal concrete materials are somewhat bigger materials. Okay, na? So somewhat bigger materials, the size of particles may vary from 0.5 to 100 micron. The normal particle size in normal cement is 0.5 to 100 micron. What will happen if you add still finer material such as silica fume, whose size is less than 0.5 micron, whose size is less than 0.5 micron. So that much quantity, 5 to 25%, if you add this one, all the whites are removed. All the whites are removed. The system will become densely packed system. So it will give up to 270 MPa strength, up to 270 MPa strength. Okay, na? Third process is pressure and warm pressing. Suppose there is a concrete material. Just now it is prepared. Okay, na? Some cube, some cylinder, some beam. If you applied slowly pressure from all the sides, and if you apply small change in the temperature, slowly increase the temperature, both these two phenomena will make the concrete very, very strong. Rise in the temperature as well as pressure increase will make the concrete very, very strong. This is called as a warm pressing principle. Applying heat and pressure simultaneously. So that is why we can achieve highest concrete. So 650 MPa, up to that much strength you can easily understand. Is that okay? Yes or no?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Sir. Okay. Some other type of cements are there which are not so important. Magnesium phosphate cement, not necessary. Okay, na? Okay. Now we will go to the next type. What is that? What is the next topic? What is the next topic? Can you read?
Properties of cement.
Properties of cement.
Property of cement. What are the different properties? First is fineness. Fineness means what? How small the particles are. See here, if a bigger particle is there, its surface area is 1. Let us say, if surface area is 1. If you break that into two small pieces, surface area will increase or decrease? Can anyone give the answer? A bigger particle, if it is broken into small pieces, its surface area will increase. What will happen if surface area will increase? Water will react more. Water particle will react more, so that cement particles available for hydration are more. Understand this property? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
If the particles are made smaller and smaller, its surface area will get increased, so that it is becoming more fine and more fine, so that the cement particles which are available for hydration of the cement are more and more, so that rate of reaction will become fast and fast, high early strength and high heat of hydration. All these are interlinked. Yes, okay, na? As the fineness increases, rate of gain of strength is also increases, rate of heat liberation is also increases. Why? More cement particles are there. More cement particles for hydration is more. So that is why we call it as finer cement, high early strength. Coarser cement, later strength. Okay, na? So that is what we call it as fineness of the cement. Okay. So there is a method to check the fineness of the cement. What is that? Air permeability test. That one we are going to see it in the next slide. It is there. Okay, na? Generally, 90 micron is the particle size. 90 micron is the particle size of the cement. Lesser than this, more should not be there. Understand? Let us say 100 grams of cement. 90 grams should be more than 90 microns. only 10 grams should be less than 90 microns. 10 grams should be less than 90 microns. I understand this point. What will happen if it is more, if it is not 10, if it is 50 and this is also 50, what will happen? More finer cement is there. So that high early strength, bigger shrinkage or high heat liberation is possible. So that is why 10% is the limit set. There is a limit such that only 10% should be less than 90 micron size. Is that clear? Fineness.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, na? Yes, can you see this graph? On the x-axis, there is a fineness. And the y-axis, there is a compressive strength. You see only this graph. As the fineness is increasing along the x-axis, what is happening to the strength here? Can anyone tell me?
Increasing in strength.
Because as the fineness increases, strength is also increasing. Fineness is increasing, strength is also increasing. Okay, na? What do you mean by setting time? See, there is a cement. When you add water, it will start reacting. It will be in fresh state. Means what? You can easily transport, you can easily place, you can give any shape of the mold. So till that time, it is moldable. It is workable. It can be changed into any shape. After some time, slowly cement will start setting. So that molding will become difficult. So that time when you add water to the time till at least it has got something set. At least it has something hard. Okay. So that time is called as water time. From the time to adding water to the time when it is set. That is called as water time.
It is called as setting time.
It is as one of the property. Why that is important? There are two setting times, initial, final. See here, let us say it is a zeroth minute. You have added cement with water. So that is considered as a zeroth minute. From there, till 30 minutes time, full fresh, full workable, any shape, any. At the 30th minute, slow setting will start. What do you mean by that one? At the 30th minute, slow setting will take place. Means what? Whatever the portion of transportation, fixing, placing, everything is there, no? Everything. So that should take place within this 30 minutes. Means what? From this point, the cement is starting setting. The setting process has started losing its plasticity. So this time is called as initial setting time. From the standards, it should not be less than 30 minutes. It should be more than 30 minutes. What will happen if it is less than 30 minutes? Suppose if it is 10 minutes, there is less time for transportation, no? There is less time for mixing, no? Whether it is a good or a bad? I think it is a bad. It should give minimum 30 minutes to transport, fix, place, compact. So that is called as initial setting time. Now, once you place here, and again, after 1 hour, 2 hour, 3 hours, 6 hours, 10 hours, after 10 hours, it will completely set here. It will completely set. That means you cannot change anything. Here you cannot change, but just started losing its plasticity. Here it is completely set, completely hard, so that you cannot do anything. But you can do the construction above this one. Means what? If you have constructed 3 meter brick wall, and after 10 hours, you can construct another layer because it has got full strength, because it is fully set. So from the zeroth time to this 10th hour, it is called as final setting time. So it should not be more than 10 hours. It should be less than 10 hours. Yes or no? Initial time, final setting time. Both are clear?
Yes, sir.
For everyone, setting time.
Yes, sir.
In that initial setting time, final setting time. Whether both are clear? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next property is soundness property. What do you mean by soundness? Suppose if you have taken a cement, you have added water, it has a reacting everything is done, and it is also set, and means what? It is made into a beam shape, rectangle shape. Suppose if there is a lime inside, lime or magnesium compounds are there inside, which have not reacted in the initial stage, but after setting, after 10 hour or 2 hour, if it is reacting with water, it will bulge. Lime, when it comes with water, magnesium, when it comes with water, it will bulge. They will make calcium carbonate, they will make magnesium carbonate, which have expansive property, means what? Volume is increasing. Suppose if it is in a big thing, inside volume is increasing, what will happen to that concrete structure?
Crack occurs.
Suppose from inside something is increasing in its volume, what will happen to the surface here?
Crack formation.
It is going to lead the cracks. So that time we call it as unsound concrete. The time the lime and magnesium are present in more, we call it as unsound concrete. If the cement is not making any cracks, means what? No lime, no magnesium are present, then we call it as sound concrete. Sound concrete is good, unsound concrete is bad. Okay, na? So unsoundness is due to lime and magnesium. So that is why soundness experiment is also tested. How to control that unsoundness? Limiting the MgO, very, very fine grinding, allowing cement to aerate, thoroughly mixing. There is one instrument, we call it as the Lee-Chatelier's apparatus. Lee-Chatelier's apparatus used to conduct the soundness test. Apart from that, you can have autoclave test also. So both are used to conduct the soundness test. How to conduct the compressive strength? See, you directly cannot make a cement cube and test it in a CTM machine. Everyone is knowing a BMT lab, CTM machine is there. You are testing bricks, you are testing cubes, correct? Na? Everyone has done that one, na? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. To test the compressive strength of cement, direct cement paste is not used. To make the cubes, direct cement paste is not used. Cement plus sand, Enor sand or standard sand is used. Cement plus standard sand is used. Which ratio? 1:3. 1 cement, 3 sand. So these two things are mixed in this proportion. Cubes have been cast. So what is the size of cube? 70 mm by 70 mm by 70 mm. This is the cube for cement cubes. Concrete cubes, the size is different. But for the cement cubes, the size is less. Okay, na? So what you are going to do? You are taking the cement, you are going to use it in sand 1:3, you are making the cubes. After making the cubes, you are keeping it in 1 day outside of the 1 day for curing. Sorry, 1 day for just to set. 1 day for just to set. After 24 hours, you are removing that molds and you are putting it in tanks. So when you put it in tanks, after 3 days, you take 2 cubes and test it in CTM machine. After 7 days, you take another 2 cubes, you test it in machine. After 28 days, you take another 2 cubes, you test it in the machine. So like that, compressive strength of cement is tested. Is that okay? How to do that testing? Cement is taken, for which a test is to be conducted. Standard sand or Enor sand is taken, 1:3 ratio is mixed, and molds are prepared molds are kept for one day for setting. After one day, the molds will be removed and only inside cubes are placed in a water tank. From there, curing will start. After 3 days, some cubes, 7 days, some cubes, 14 days, 28 days, like that, cubes will be tested. Okay, na? So that strength is considered as a compressive strength of cement. You can have to take the average of that one. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Hydration.
Yes, sir.
Compressive strength test. Okay. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next is heat of hydration. Heat of hydration means what? Whenever cement is there, when you add water, it will react, you know. During reaction, heat is liberated. That is what we call it as heat of hydration. Generally, it is 120 calories of heat per gram of cement is liberated. How much? 120 calories of heat per gram of cement is used. Why this is important? In cold weather concreting, you want heat to be liberated more in the early stage. In hot weather concreting, you want less heat of liberation in the early stage. Are you understanding this point? Why this is important? Yes, sir. Yes, sir. No, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Heat liberation is fast. Heat liberation is fast in early stages. Means what? Within 7 days, lot of heat is liberated. After 7 days to 28 days, heat is liberated, but it is less. Heat is liberated, it is less. Another point. As the temperature of surrounding increases, as the temperature of surrounding increases, heat liberation will also increase. Why? Temperature increase will make the reaction faster. Which reaction? Reaction between water and cement will become faster so that more heat is liberated. When the temperature of the surrounding is increased. Are you understand this point? When the temperature is increased, heat liberation is also increases. In the early stages of hydration, that is within 7 days, heat liberation is more. After 7 days to 28 days, heat liberation is less. Okay? Is that okay? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Ah, good.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Specific gravity, everyone knows. Okay, what do you mean by specific gravity? You have conducted the labs. Okay. Normally, specific gravity of cement is taken as 3.15. Depends upon the production. Okay. All the chemical properties we have studied. What are the chemical properties? That reaction, no? What is that reaction? Calcium, what is that? Four compounds are there. What are the four compounds? Four bogies compounds are there, no? C3S, C2S, C3A, C4A. All these things react with water and will give CSH gel and will give calcium hydroxide. Okay, na? All these things are what? Chemical properties. All these things are what? Chemical properties. Okay? Yes or no?
Sir.
Okay? Insoluble residue. What do you mean by insoluble residue? The part of the cement which is not at all reacting with water. The part of the cement which is not at all reacting with water is called as insoluble residue. Okay. By the general thing, whether it should be more or whether it should be less in a given cement.
Less.
Everyone?
Less, sir.
Less.
Others, what happened? Others? Bhavana?
Yes, sir.
What do you guess? Whether it is less or more? Whether insoluble residue should be less or more?
Less or less.
It should be less. It should be less. Okay. How to find out this insoluble residue? There is one small experiment. What is small experiment? You take water. Okay. You take cement, okay? you take concentrated HCl, you mix, you boil, you mix and you boil. The field, the whatever material is there, no, it is washed with sodium carbonate solution, and water and hydrochloric acid. So it is washed. First is cement, water, concentrated HCl is boiled. After boiling, it is washed with the sodium carbonate solution and with water and with HCl, and one filter paper is taken, and this solution, washed solution, is poured from here. Whatever is passing through that filter, it is good part of the cement. Whatever which is left out on the filter paper, whatever that portion which is left out on the top of the this one, that is called as residue. Residue means what? Which is not passing, na? Yes or no? Residue means what? Which is passing or which is not passing? Residue.
Not passing.
Particles which are not passing.
Very good. Particles which are not passing are called as residue. So whatever the content which is left over that filter paper is called as insoluble residue. Is called as insoluble residue. Clear this point?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So there is a limit of 0.85%. There is a limit of 0.85%. Is that okay? Yes, no.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Tomorrow I will take at 10:30. We will complete this portion, testing of cement. Is that okay? Tomorrow 10:30.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now time is over or still time is there? Now.
Over.
Yes, sir.
Can anyone tell me whether now still time is there or whether it is completed?
Over, sir. Sir, time over.
Time over. Okay. So what we will do tomorrow at 10:30, we will start with this one. Okay.
Yes. Yes, sir. Thank you.
Any doubts? So many people are there.
No, sir.
Maximum, people are there. I will ask one by one. What happened to Abu Bakr? Any doubts?
No, sir. Akash? The last one.
Which one? Which part, Baba?
Which the one? Last one.
Insoluble residue, huh? Last insoluble residue.
Yes, sir.
This one, no? This one?
Yes, sir.
What? Residue, insoluble residue means what? The part of the cement which is not reacting. Suppose you take 100 grams of cement, full 100 grams of cement is not reacting with water. Something which is there which is very, very bad, let us say it is 5 grams. So which is not at all reacting with water, so no strength. So how much quantity is there which is not reacting, you want to find out. So that is called as insoluble residue experiment. So how to do that experiment?
Yes, sir.
You cannot take a cement and put it with water and take on a, filter paper. So to have something extra, no? So for that, you take cement, you take water, and you take HCl, hydrochloric acid. You add all those things and you boil for 10 minutes. Later on, it is washed with the sodium carbonate solution and water and HCl. So all the washed thing is taken into a beaker, and over that you have a filter paper. And you all the things is poured here, poured like this on the filter paper, it is poured. So whichever is passing, good part of the cement. Whichever is not passing, which is left out over the filter paper, is a bad part of the cement. And that bad part of the cement is called as what? Insoluble residue. It's called as insoluble residue. Now it is clear?
Yes, sir.
Now it is clear or not?
Yes, sir. Clear.
Okay. Akash, Akki, now what about you? Have you understood all the parts?
Yes, sir.
Everything you understood?
Yes.
Arud, Arud.
Yes, sir.
Everything you have understood?
Yes, sir. Understood.
Okay. Danish Mirji. Danish Mirji.
Sir, crushing strength, sir.
Crushing strength of?
Sir, crushing strength understand.
ಯಾವುದು ಅದು ಕ್ರಷಿಂಗ್ ಅಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಕಾಂಪ್ರೆಸಿವ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಇದು ಅಲ್ಲ
ಸಾರಿ ಸರ್
ಕಾಂಪ್ರೆಸಿವ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಅದಲ್ಲ ನೀವು ಹೇಳು
ಹಾ ಸರ್ ಹಾ ಹಾ ಸರ್ ಹಾ ಹಾ ಸರ್
ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಹೇಳ್ತೇನೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕಾಂಪ್ರೆಸಿವ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸಿಮೆಂಟ್ ದ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ರೆಸಿವ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬರಂಗಿಲ್ಲ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಈಗ ನೀವು ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಸಿಮೆಂಟ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ಕ್ಯೂಬ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗ್ತಿತ್ತು ಜಲ್ದಿ ಕ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ ಬಿದ್ದು ಹೊಡೆದು ಬಿಡ್ತೈತೆ ಅದ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಆ ಪ್ರೊಸೀಜರ್ ಹೆಂಗದಪ್ಪ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸಿಮೆಂಟ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ಅದಕ್ಕ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಆ ಸ್ಯಾಂಡಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಎನ್ಓರ್ ಸ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅಥವಾ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅಂತೆ ಆ ಸ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಸಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಎಷ್ಟಿರ್ತದ 1:3 ಇರ್ತದೆ ಸೊ ಆ 1:3 ಒಳಗೆ ಸಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಆ ಸ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆಡ್ ಮಾಡಿ ವಾಟರ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಕ್ಯೂಬ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಸಣ್ಣ ಕ್ಯೂಬ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಆ ಕ್ಯೂಬ್ಸ್ ತಗೊಂಡೋಗಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರ ಆ ಕ್ಯೂಬ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಒಂದ್ ದಿನ ಹಂಗ ಇಡ್ತಾರೆ ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಮೌಲ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತಾವ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ನು ಮೌಲ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತಾವ ಒಂದಿನ ಆದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಆ ಮೌಲ್ಡ್ಸ್ ನ ಬಿಸ್ತಾರ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ರಿಮೂವ್ ದ ಮೌಲ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ರಿಮೂವ್ ದ ಮೌಲ್ಡ್ಸ್ ದ ಕ್ಯೂಬ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕೆಪ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಟ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಫಾರ್ ವಾಟ್ ರೀಸನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ರೀಸನ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಕ್ಯೂಬ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕೆಪ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಟ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 3 days ಕ್ಯೂಬ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ರೆಸಿವ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 6 days ಕ್ಯೂಬ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ರೆಸಿವ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಹಿಂಗ 3 ದಿನಕ್ಕೊಮ್ಮೆ 6 ದಿವಸಕ್ಕೊಮ್ಮೆ 14 ದಿವಸಕ್ಕೊಮ್ಮೆ ಹಿಂಗೆ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಚಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತಾವ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ಗ್ರಾಫ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತಾವ ಆ ಗ್ರಾಫ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಏನ್ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಓಕೆ ನಮ್ದು 3 ದಿವಸದ ಕ್ಯೂಬ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ 14 MPa ಐತಿ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ಎಷ್ಟದಪ್ಪ 15 ಐತಿ ನಮ್ದು ಕಡಿಮೆ ಅದನೋ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಅದನೋ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಸರಿ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ದು ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಐತಿ ಹಿಂಗ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಅದ ಎಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲೋದ ಯಾರು ಕೇಳ್ದ ಅರುಡ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕೇಳ್ದೆ ದಾನೇಶ್ ಹಲೋ
ಹಾ ಸರ್ ದಾನೇಶ್ ದಾನೇಶ್ ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಸರ್
ಹಾ ಈಗ ಅರ್ಥ ಆತನಪ್ಪ
ಹಾ ಸರ್ ಅನುಷ್ಠಾನ ಹತ್ರ
ಈಗ ಅನುಷ್ಠಾನ ಹತ್ರ ಓಕೆ ಹಾ ನಕ್ಷತ್ರ ಮೇಡಮ್
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್
ಏನಾರ ಹೇಳ್ರಪ್ಪ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಟೆಲ್ ಮೀ ಇನ್ ದ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ಡ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್
Understood. Yes, sir.
Okay. See how Danesh has asked, how Abu Bakr has asked. I want that type of doubts. Please ask. Okay.
Yes,
Nakshatra, be attentive in the class. Nihal.
Yes, sir.
Ha, understand aitanappa illa?
Yes, sir.
Trivita, any other doubts idiya?
Illa, sir.
Illa. Okay. Prajwal Bagalkoti.
Sir.
Any doubts? Anything you want to explain sir. Once again?
No,
sir. No? Shruti Nayak?
Yes, sir.
Any doubts, ma?
No, sir. Please. Everything is clear.
Everything sir. Is clear? Okay. Okay. So now, tomorrow, 10:30, yes, mathematics yes. class is not there. Mathematics, they are taking at what time? Can anyone tell me?
9:30.
Okay, 9:30 to 10:30 they are taking. From 10:30 it is no class is there, no? So I will take at 10:30, okay na? Okay, from 10:30 to 11:30 I will take. After that there is class structure. Okay, okay, okay. Thank you everyone. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.